Bennie R. Mitchell Jr. was the truth. He did not hide the truth from anybody. He loved his family, God, Jesus, the church, and Reverend Martin Luther King.
It is projected by 1990 census will show that Savannah will have more than a 53% black population. What hope do we have for the future if most of our citizens see no hope?
The political scene in Savannah changed when Dr. Mitchell started to speak up.
Elected officials are, quote, not leaders. They are elected leaders.
It is said Reverend Mitchell single-handedly elected a mayor.
And if any elected official in here don't do what the folks say, your time is limited.
The issue of naming a street in honor of Dr. King, that was another struggle.
Don't have us marching up and down the street to City Hall to beg for a street.
Any city worth its weight in salt even has a Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard or drive.
Give us the street because it's right to have a street or avenue named after King.
The mayor had the audacity, of course, to meet with some other folks.
I will join a consensus of city council to name West Broad Street in honor of Dr. Martin Luther King.
I said, when you get up to make your comments, and it was about 5,000 folks in the Civic Center, I said, you make them aware that he won't ever get up and cross you like that again.
This is a glorious Martin Luther King Observance Day here in Savannah, Georgia.
And we're standing here with Reverend Bennie Mitchell.
Hi.
Good morning, Reverend Mitchell.
Good morning.
It was exciting when we first had our first march. We had very few persons lining the streets.
Reverend Mitchell serves as chairman of the MLK Observance Association. Because of his dedication and inspiration, listen to this. Savannah's observance is rated the second largest observance in the world.
I don't really think that Reverend Mitchell ever got the proper credit that he deserves for the Martin Luther King Observance Day that's going on right now in the city of Savannah.
As I look around, I see probably the largest crowd that I have ever seen for this particular parade.
And the reason why it's growing so is because if we did not have this day, the sensitivity would not be there for the community.
I consider Pastor Mitchell as being a little Moses.
He was a preacher. Preachers love to hear him preach.
Well, Reverend, how can we keep Dr. King's dream alive? By eliminating the evils of racism, unemployment, violence, and apathy.
You know, Con Ed was a concept that was ahead of its time for Savannah.
Our people need businesses.
You could always hear Reverend Mitchell's voice making sure that businesses, particularly minority-owned and woman-owned businesses, got a piece of the pie.
He did not try to sell me on it. He let it speak for itself.
As you know, Con Ed is more than a building. It's Bennie Mitchell's vision.
Put your hands together now and welcome the Reverend Bennie R. Mitchell Jr. Come on, y'all.
Heard Reverend Mitchell sing for the first time, and I was thoroughly impressed that that kind of vocals, harmony, could come out of this man.
And I loved his singing so much. Oh God, he could sing. He stirred my soul when he sang.
Oh my God, one more. Oh!
He loved people.
Very dynamic.
And the golden voice.
May God bless you. May he keep you. Keep on supporting. Keep on praying. Keep on